Hey everyone, Ryan here at etrailer. Today on our 2023 Kia Sorento, we're going to be showing you how to install the Curt custom fit vehicle wiring harness. Before we get into that though, let's just take a minute. We'll check this out and make sure it's going to work for you. With the Sorento being a capable SUV, people tend to do a lot of different things with them. You know, perfect example today, our neighbor has a roof rack up there to haul around roof mounted accessories and came in today for a trailer hitch and this wiring. And if you plan on pulling a trailer, you're gonna need a way to power up the lights on that trailer, right? That way you're safe and legal. And that's where a kit like this is gonna come into play. It's going to send all the necessary signals. You'll get your brake lights, your running lights, and your turn signals. Now, when it comes to the Sorento, there's quite a few different wiring kits available for it, and it can kind of be confusing trying to figure out the right one that's going to work for you. There's some that are designed to work with the Sorentos that have the factory tow package, like our wiring today that we're checking out, and then there's other kits that are designed to work with the vehicles that don't have that factory tow package, some with LED taillights, so on and so forth. What we're going to try to do here is explain a few things that you can do to figure out what kit is actually going to work. The vast majority of these Sorentos that I've personally seen do have the factory tow package, right? And all it is just a little connector plug on the driver's side here underneath of a panel. If you have that plug there, chances are really good that factory tow package kits are gonna work. You just plug it right in there, power everything up. Just because your vehicle doesn't have a trailer hitch on it right out of the box doesn't mean you're not gonna have that tow package plug, right? So again, we put the hitch on today, didn't come with one from the factory, and that plug was still there. So it's definitely worth checking. You know, it takes a couple seconds to lower that panel down, which we'll show you in the installation, to see if that's there. If you don't see that plug there, then you're gonna need to get the types of kits that plug into the back of your taillights, get power and everything that way. It's really important, use our fit guide, see our installation notes and our tech tips to kind of get you going in the right direction. To compare our Curt kit to another one available, this one's made by Tekancha, and honestly, no major differences really. The Tekancha wiring is a little bit longer, but it doesn't really matter on this vehicle because it's so easy to mount everything up anyway. You don't really need this extra length. So honestly, you can't really go wrong with either one of these kits. Other than that, at the end of the day, no, you can't really ask for too much more. Really simple kit, and it's gonna get the job done. As far as the installation goes, this is something that just about anyone should be able to do. You know, like I said, you lower that panel down, which is real easy. Plug it in, zip tie a few wires up, route it over here, and you're in pretty good shape as far as that goes. If you're gonna be setting up a trailer hitch and maybe some other components too, and don't really wanna try to tackle everything at once, I definitely understand that. You can always use our dealer locator network to help you find a shop and get you going in the right direction as far as, you know, finding one that can set everything up for you. But with that in mind, why don't we go ahead and get started on the wiring now. To begin our installation, we're gonna be working underneath the back of our Sorento. And what I done was temporarily lower and remove the spare tire just to give us a little bit more room to work. It's something you don't have to do, but it's entirely up to you. We're gonna be working over here on the driver's side to get this underbody panel removed. Our panel is gonna be held in place with three push pin style fasteners along this bottom edge here. To get these out, you can take a flathead screwdriver, just pry underneath the head of it, and you can pull the base out. And then along this edge here, on our frame, there's gonna be two more fasteners, one here, the other one's just kind of tucked up towards the back there. And you can take a 14 millimeter socket and an extension. You can just unthread these by hand. And what I like to do with them, a lot of times it kind of gets to a point where it just wants to keep spinning. If that happens, just put a little downward pressure on the panel while you spin it, and that'll get it to release. Lower this down and set it off to the side for now. If you look at this piece of plastic here, behind it, about in the middle, you can reach back there and feel a connector plug that it's not going to anything. And that's the plug that we're gonna be working with. To make it easier to get to and see, there's this little black fastener coming through. That's what's holding it in. If you take a pair of needle nose pliers, just kind of squeeze that in, you're able to release that plug and pull it out like this. There will be what's called a dummy cap on it, and that's just there from the factory to help keep the terminals protected, so we will need to remove that. Just squeeze in, get it removed. We'll take our factory connector now, and this is just gonna plug right into our new harness. Clip them together, and then we'll have our fuse holder. You can take the included fuse, we'll put that into position. And what I'll do is just mount up our converter box and route our four-way flat connector over towards our trailer hitch and show you how it turned out. Here's how I mounted up the converter box here. In the plastic, I just drilled two small quarter-inch holes. Be sure you don't hit anything behind there, of course, and then I just use a zip tie to wrap the converter box around it. And as far as how I routed our wiring, pretty straightforward. Just have it going like this. It cuts along through here. And then it drops down. And I have it secured to the safety chain opening on our trailer hitch. With everything in place now, we can go ahead and reinstall the underbody panel the opposite way that we removed it. It is a good idea to test your wiring to make sure that it's working properly. I like to use one of these testers as opposed to just plugging into my trailer. And I say that because if your trailer happens to have any issues, it might mislead you, thinking it's something you did on the vehicle side. But that in mind, we'll try our left turn signal, our right turn signal. We'll hit our brakes and turn on our taillights. Now that we verified our wiring works, I'm gonna clean up the install look a little bit by taking some wire loom, putting it over there just to kind of help it blend in a little bit better. That'll finish up our look at and our installation of the Curt custom fit vehicle wiring harness on our 2023 Kia Sorento.